them all up, you gotta shake them for 2 to 3 minutes. You really, really want to shake them. It really does help get you a good coat, get you an even coat. And obviously, it's not the highest grade, best paint you can get, but I'll tell you what, I'm gonna give you a secret. This is friggin' tractor paint. So, it's made for that old truck or old tractor out in the field. Ain't nothing better than tractor paint, in my opinion. And rotors. Covered and clean. Think that you got a little bit on it. Might not be a bad idea to make sure you didn't, and to like wipe it off. You got to run that freaking wire brush over it, the one that's on the drill. But after one coat, that wire brush will knock it right off. But obviously, the more coats, the harder it is. So keep that edge clean, but we're going to run RTP on that, and it's going to go right back on the truck. We're getting all these parts on there today, so let's go put them ball joints in. And actually, we could also put together... We could actually go ahead and put together... tie rod ends. And actually, this one is still on the truck. We could actually go pull it off and get it put on there real quick. Let's see what we got. Need these ball joints put in. Get these ball joints put in, and then we can get the calipers or rotors, calipers put on there. Looks like we may need a little bit of touch up. That thing is just filthy. Like, I still even miss some, like, just, wow. Looking dirty. I power washed it, guys. Like, so we are going to order these, get new of these bushings. And that bar I just showed you inside is this one, the one I didn't paint. No reason to paint it if we're going to replace it. So, that one right there.